Son, and the Holy Spirit. The peace of the Lord be with you. The scriptures remind us of the importance of walking in the life of Christ. As we pray the Mass, let us seek forgiveness when we have not walked in that way of Christ. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty and invisible God, who dispersed the darkness of this world by the coming of your light, look, we pray, with serene countenance upon us, that we may acclaim with fitting praise the greatness of the nativity of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, the way we may be sure that we know Jesus is to keep his commandments. Whoever says, I know him, but does not keep his commandments is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. This is the way we may know that we are in union with him. Whoever claims to abide in him or to walk just as he walked. Beloved, I am writing no new commandment to you, but an old commandment that you had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word that you have heard. And yet, I do not write a new commandment to you, which holds true in him and among you. For the darkness is passing away, and the true light is already shining. Whoever says he is in the light, yet hates his brother, is still in darkness. Whoever loves his brother remains in the light, and there is nothing in him to cause a fall. Whoever hates his brother is in darkness. He walks in darkness, and does not know where he is going, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all your lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among all peoples, his wondrous deeds. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. The Lord made the heavens, splendor and majesty go before him. Praise and grandeur are in his sanctity. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice.
Just as it is written in the law of the Lord, Every male that opens the womb should be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer the sacrifice of a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons, in accordance with the dictate in the law of the Lord. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel. And the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Christ of the Lord. He came in spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought this child, Jesus, to perform the custom of the law in regard to him, he took him in his arms and blessed God, saying, "Lord, now let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of the people of Israel." The child's father and mother were amazed at what was said about him. And Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that it will be contradicted, and you yourself a sword will pierce, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed." The Gospel of the Lord. As you well know, as you get older, it's hard to see, right? You clean your glasses, and especially, I don't think it's going to be sunny today. So if you want to see something, you know your best friend is this crazy phone, because on it has this really cool light. And I've used it. I was doing something with my father the other day, and neither one of us could see what we needed to see. It was, we were shopping, and there was a label, and he wanted to see something on the label and see what was in it. And I couldn't see it. He couldn't see it. So I got out the flashlight and put it on there. "Okay, Dad, can you see it?" Why do I share that with you? Well, today's about light and darkness. John 1 is about light and darkness. And so, how do we walk in the light? And that's the number one thing. When we really want to see, physically it's the phone. Spiritually, emotionally, it's the Lord. You know, because we really need to live in the light. When you don't live in the light, you get in trouble. Did you ever try to go into a room in the darkness and bump your foot? I did that. I didn't turn on the light. I thought I knew where all the items were. And I hit my baby toe, and it hurt like crazy, and I fractured it. And it's like crazy, how did you just, boom, you know, why, I didn't have the light on. You can't see in the darkness. You think you can see in the darkness. Not always, you might get a surprise, right? You gotta have the light on. Today is about turning on the light of Christ in our hearts. And when we receive the Eucharist, Lord, turn on the light of my heart, that I may love. Truly love. It says in John 1 about hating. Hating takes up too much energy. Let it go. Lord, turn on the light of my heart. Think about going in the bedroom. You know, you gotta turn on the light so you see where everything's at. Otherwise, you're gonna fall and trip, right? Today's about turning on the light of your heart. Lord, turn on the light of my heart. Help me, help me, help me. Fill me up with your love. Fill me up with your love. That I may bring the light of Christ to the world. As we're in the fifth day of Christmas, we offer our prayers for our world, our nation, and community of faith. And let us pray for the church throughout the world. May the love of Christ continue to transform us. Be people of light. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the doctors, the nurses, the healthcare givers. continue to fight the battle of coronavirus on this planet Earth, that people may walk in the light. You know, there's no vaccine for selfishness. And so, Lord, help us to walk in the light, that we may wear masks, we may keep social distance, and we may wash our hands and stay healthy. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who govern nations, may the Spirit bless them with wisdom, right judgment, and their efforts to protect sanctity of life from beginning to end. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country, that we may be a sign of unity. We have more in common than we don't. So, Lord, help us be the very best for one another. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the petitions we hold within the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this fifth day of Christmas. We thank you for your word that teaches us the significance of living in your light, not in the darkness. Help us as we try to turn on the light within our hearts, as we try to transform the world in your likeness, and offer up these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, and will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For through him, the holy exchange that restores our life has shone forth today in splendor. And so, in the company of the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy,
Holy, Holy.
Heavenly and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Now, in all of our Mass intention this day for James Power, Mitch Brittell, Jacqueline and Linda Brittell, and all have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, St. Joseph, with the blessed apostles, martyrs, St. Catherine, and all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, so that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
now let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say to the Lord, my soul shall be with you.
pray, Almighty God, that by the power of these holy mysteries, our life may constantly sustain, be constantly sustained through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So what does it take to turn on the light of our hearts? You know, maybe a little kindness today, a little patience, maybe a little